Hello YouTube, it's Final once again, bringing you a basic tanking guide. I am no means a main tank, but when I do tank, this is how I do it. So I'll give you a lowdown, show you what I do, skills and armor, and hopefully you can bring this into your tanking. So what we'll do is we'll start with a sword and shield. So basically here I'm mostly in Swordmaster with a little bit of the Defender side. I'd rather do a bit more DPS than damage mitigation. This is how we like to run in our group. So the skills that I'm picking are Sturdy Shield for the additional 15% armor. Shield Rush down into Improved Rush, but missing out the slow of Intimidating Rush. And then Sturdy Grip, which is the stamina damage is reduced by 15% so that I can block a little bit more. And when you block an attack, gain 10% Fortify. That'll add with the Sacred Ground, Orb of Healing and all of that. And then Recuperation. All incoming heals and regeneration increase by 10%. So any heals coming in, you're going to get 10% extra more. And then Defiant Stance is a must when you're tanking. This is the AoE Taunt. As long as you've got a Ruby Gem in your weapons, which is a must, pop that as soon as you go in and you'll grab all the aggro. We go down into the second one, which is if your health is above 50, damage reduction is increased by 20%. I don't take restoration because I don't feel the need of, when it's over, getting a 15% heal when you've got a healer on you. So we go over to Swordmaster. The big one is reverse stab. So basically reverse stab is going to replenish your abilities. So every time you reverse stab, it will do 25% reduction on your abilities on the other side. So that is, I would say, a must so that you can do your rotation, you can keep your aggro, you can keep using Defiant Stance and things like that. So it's quite important. So we start top right. Achilles heal, the final attack on your light attack, chain inflicts 20% slow, so you're slowing the enemies. Empowered stab, which is granting you 30% empower for 5 seconds. Precision, sword and shield critical chance increase, just gives you a little bit more damage. Again, we've got some empower stacks, 3%, it can stack 5 times, so 15% empower. Opportunist deals 10% more damage to slowed foes, which stacks with your Achilles heal. Confidence with health is full deals 50% more damage. Obviously as a tank your health is going to be fluctuating, so it does help for your start, and if you're topped off or if they're all stunned you do get a little bit more damage. Then critical precision, on critical gain 20% haste. This can help with you moving out of the way of a few slow attacks. And then what we choose in our group is leadership. So while holding a sword and shield, the damage of all the group members increased by 10%. So we run a lot of lights, so 10% is quite an increase on the damage. So obviously with my sword, I've got a Carnelian gem in for the taunts. So I'm using a hammer. So everything in the hammer tree is completely down to you and up to you, but what I would suggest is make sure you use shockwave when you're tanking, because as long as you've got a Carnelian gem in, you've got a taunt there as well. It'll stun them and you'll taunt everything in an AoE attack in an AoE area, so that will help you. If your abilities on your sword are down, switch over to your hammer, do an AoE taunt, switch back into your sword and shield and get the block on. Wait till your abilities are open then. Attributes, we run in our group a 300-200 attribute with food. So I'm using the carrot cake, which will take me up to 300, which gives me grit so I can't get knocked or dazed. And 200 constitution is normally more than enough as long as you've got a decent set of gear. So what I'm going to have a look at now is the gear. So what we're going to now is, obviously I'm on full heavy, so this is for my Laz gear, because it's Laz this week. The gems will all change depending on what week it is and what affliction it is, but this is what I'm using in Lazarus, which is the Chardis set, which you can get off of Chardis, last boss in Lazarus. Everything here has refreshing ward, so every time I get hit 4 times, all my active cooldowns are reduced by 1.9. I've got an ancient ward, which you need in Lazarus. Obviously for Genesis you're going to need Angry Earth, and for the corrupted ones you're going to need Corrupting Ward, and for Barnacles you're going to need Lost Ward. So obviously change your gear to whatever dungeon you're doing. It does help and it does mitigate a lot of the damage. And invigorated weakness, disease and exhaust and rends expire 11% faster. So I've got the Chardis headrest, the chest wrap, which is all the same down here. They're all strength with refreshing ward, ancient ward and invigorated. So they're all the same. all the way down. So if I go to my shield, on here you can get a better shield. This isn't the best, but I quite like it. So it's got sturdy energy. When block and hit, you get 30% stamina, so you gain 39% increased stamina regen for 6 seconds. Quite a good one for your blocking. So if you're doing your block, hit, block, your stamina bar should level out and you should be able to keep that block up. Hatred is another one which is contentious. Some people say it works, some people say it doesn't, but I quite like it. It generates 145% more threat, and just ignore that luck at the bottom because, yeah, what is luck? We'll go into that at another time. So what I'm using here is the Garden's Amulet. I don't have a better amulet at the moment, but this has got Refreshing Ward, so it stacks with mine, and also it's got the health, which you gain 9.4% maximum health. What I would like, instead of Shirking Deliberate, is to have the perk which increases the healing done on me, but that's one for you if you want to spend into that. Obviously, I'm not a main tank, so I just make a mix and match gear, but that's what you could use. I'm using the Smooth Bone Ring. It's got leeching, so I get a little bit of life. Hearty for a bit more stamina, and Keen Awareness for 12% crit chance. Obviously, there's many other rings that you can use, and probably many other better rings, but I've got that 625, so I'm going to pop that on. And then I've got an old ring that I got from a gypsum cast, which is quite good. It's got Refreshing Ward on again. Refreshing Toast, which the cooldowns go lower, and you gain 0.48% health every second, which doesn't sound a lot, but it does tick and it does help. And obviously potions, you should be popping your potions at every time you possibly can to help the healer. So yeah, that does help. With my weapons, I'm using Curiosity Greed, it's Constitution Keen, Hatred again, 145%, so I'm getting nearly 300% more threat on the mobs and keenly fortified. And for my hammer, I'm using the Woods Warden, which is Keen Vicious and keenly fortified, so just a little bit of a boost onto fortified, just in case Sacred Ground is not down or something like that. You're going to be at fortified cap, which will mitigate a little bit more damage. So that is basically how I run my tanking setup. Obviously, for a lot of guys that are main tanks, they're going to have a different view on this, but this is just a rough basic guide of what you can do to set up for your tanking. Obviously, a lot of my gear is 625. There's a couple of 600 pieces. I've worked a little bit on this, but not much. So this will set me up from up to like an M6, M7. I could tank pretty healthily on that in Lazarus. So yeah, that is my basic tanking gear. Hopefully that gives you a little bit of insight on how you should be tanking. I'll give you a little bit of a lowdown of what I would do. So when I'm going in, the first thing I'm doing is collecting all the mobs as I run around, and then the first button I'll do is Defiant Stance, which will give an AoE taunt to everything that I've just pulled, so it'll pull it off all of the healers and the DPS and bring it into me. And then as soon as they're all clumped up, I'm going to give it a reverse stab so that my cooldown of Defiant Stance comes up, and then I'll start blocking. And then look at your stamina bar, keep an eye on it. When you feel like the need is, I'll swap over to my hammer. I'll put another taunt out so that any damage that's gone out, that people are putting out, I'll bring the aggro back into me. And then I'll be swapping back over to my sword and shield with a block. And then reverse stab again into the pack, which should then bring Defiant Stance up. So I should be rotating through Defiant Stance, reverse stab, going into Shockwave, coming back, blocking, reverse stab, Defiant Stance. Obviously, if you've got like a mob that you can stun, you can use your shield bash, it's not a problem. But what the aim of the game is for a tank is to keep as much aggro as you can in a bulk so that your DPS can AoE them down. But yet, don't forget that when you're taunting, don't just hold the taunt button down, because your stamina bar is going to get an absolute pounding. Try and match it with their attack. So when you see them attacking, block. When you don't, give them a couple of sweeps to gain some more aggro, and then block again. And then, as you can see, the stamina bar will go up. Block, and that's what you need to do. You need to keep that and keep an eye on your stamina management, because as a tank, stamina management is quite a big one. So as long as you keep an eye on that, you come out of block, hit a couple of times, Shockwave will stun them, so that'll give you a bit more time, but just keep an eye on that stamina as well. And basically, that is everything you need to know to tank. There is other bits and bobs, obviously. You want to make sure that you're keeping as much aggro as you can. Don't just run out and let mobs hit the healers and things like that. Just be aware, but Defiant Stance is going to be your friend. AoE taunt them, keep them in, block them, manage your stamina, reverse stab for a refresh, and you are good to go. Hopefully that gave you a small insight into tanking. There's probably a lot better tanks out there, but I thought I'd give you a little insight, and hopefully it will help you just improve that little bit more. So I will see you again. Thanks for watching. If you did like it and you have liked some of my videos, please think about hitting that subscribe button because it does help. And do think about hitting the like button. Any comments, leave in the comments. Even if it's bad or criticism, I don't mind. Just leave the comments. I'm more than happy to reply. I am not the best player. I'm just doing these videos to help the people that don't know as much as me, which is probably not that many. But thank you very much, and I will see you on the next one. Bye.